correct. Next category.
Well, Dave Rooney, I'll take pranks on grandma.
You're at Thanksgiving dinner.
Hiding her dentures inside the turkey. Amazing! That is correct! Itching pattern in her orthopedic shoes. Animal dress as humans. That's my favorite one.
Oh, hello. Welcome to my living room. Wait. Oh no. Oh no. Okay. Hold on one second. Hold on, just one sec. Hold on. Oh, no, come on. No, no, come on. Oh, come on. Oh. Oh, come on, let's do it. Where are you? No, not that. Oh. Come on, where are my jeans? Ah! Ah! Miss Connie, where did you put my socks? Come on, come on. Ah. Ah. Hey, I'm so sorry. Give me one second. Check this out.
Hey everyone, it's time to do our word decoration. Repeat after me. I'm the head and not the tail. I'm a bunny and not beneath. I'm less coming in. I'm less going out. Everything I set my hands to will prosper. That was amazing. Enjoy the rest of the video.
When night is falling, when fear is calming, still you're calling me. Yeah, when faith is lost and my hope exhausted, you will be my strength. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. I've decided I'm not giving up. You won't give up on me.
You love it.
Jesus, and Jesus is the best at forgiving. And it reminded me of the story of one time when I was a kid, my mom asked me to help her make this amazing, amazing dish. See, we were cooking for our entire family, and one of our favorite dishes was this potato casserole. And I know that casserole sounds kind of nasty, but trust me, it's delicious. So she said, Tyler, this is what I need you to do. I need you to cut up all the potatoes, and I need you to follow these instructions very carefully. You're gonna do potatoes, then a little bit of sauce, then a little bit of salt, and then more potatoes, then a little bit of sauce, and a little bit of salt, then more potatoes, then a little bit of salt, and a little bit of sauce, and keep going until the whole pan is filled up. So I did that. I washed the potatoes, I peeled the potatoes, I cut the potatoes, and it came time to start laying out the casserole. So I put the potatoes down, then I took the sauce and spread it out evenly, and it started to look so good. And then I thought, okay, next was the salt. I gotta put the salt in. So I grabbed the thing of salt, and for a split second I thought, maybe I should ask my mom how much salt I should use. But then I got to thinking, it's okay, I'm probably a really good cook. I could do this by myself. So I grabbed the salt and I sprinkled a little bit, and a little bit more, and a little bit more. Then I started all over again. I took the potatoes, laid them out evenly, took the sauce, put more sauce on it, grabbed the salt, thought, everybody loves salt, so a little bit here, a little bit here, a little bit here, and then start all over again. Put the potatoes, put some sauce, grab the salt, a little bit here, a little bit here, a little bit here, took some potatoes, added the sauce, grabbed the salt, a little bit here, a little bit here, a little bit here, one last layer, took the potatoes, put the sauce, then grabbed the salt and thought, you know what? I'm gonna make sure that we have enough salt. So I really made sure that all the potatoes got enough salt. Put it in the oven, it cooked, it came out, and it looked so good, and it smelled delicious, like incredible. Like I don't know how I didn't just stick my face into it right away, but I waited, and later on, we all sat down at the table, and we had all the food there, and we all started to cut into the food and serve ourselves and put it on our plate, and everyone was so excited about this potato casserole because we love it so much. And as everybody went in to take a bite, they made a weird face. And I'm watching everyone thinking, well, what's wrong with them? This is the most delicious casserole they've probably ever tasted, right? So I cut a little piece off and I put it in my mouth. And I immediately spit it all out, because it tasted so salty. It was so disgusting. Like, I had put way too much salt in this dish. In fact, I had kind of ruined it. And my mom told me that it was okay, that everybody makes mistakes, and I felt really bad, and I apologized to everybody for ruining their favorite dish, and they all said, it's okay, we forgive you. And that made me feel really good, because being forgiven feels really good. But there's another story in the Bible where the disciples kind of had to ask Jesus, just like I should have asked, about the right ingredients that they needed for their own life. You see, Peter went to Jesus one day and said, Jesus, how many times should I forgive someone? Now, I'm sure Peter was thinking that Jesus was gonna be like, two times. After you've forgiven them two times, then that's it. You don't have to forgive them anymore. But Jesus said something that I think shocked all of them. He didn't just say it's two or three or four or five or six or seven times. Jesus said you should forgive them 70 times seven. That's a lot, that's 490. Now, Jesus wasn't just telling us an exact number, that once we hit 490 times of forgiving one person, then we can be angry at them for the rest of our lives. Jesus was trying to teach us something. He was trying to show us a way that we should live our lives, because if we do, then they're gonna be better. Jesus was addressing that in our lives, when we model them like Jesus, that we're gonna start to walk and act and be like Jesus, and our lives are gonna be better because of it. And Jesus, in his life, had no unforgiveness. Because unforgiveness in our hearts, not our physical hearts, but our spiritual hearts, where thoughts live and decisions are made and where Jesus belongs, unforgiveness there can actually start to do terrible things to our soul. It kind of looks like this.
Unforgiveness is a nasty thing. No, no, much nastier. Unforgiveness is this. It's when you hold on to bad things that someone else did to you. It doesn't actually hurt the other person or make them feel bad. The Bible says it's not our job to get back at people. God says our job is to forgive. Repay meanness with kindness. Unforgiveness is like tying yourself to a ball and chain and then dragging that behind you everywhere you go. That'll show 'em. Remember, unforgiveness is when someone hurts you and you hold on to that pain and never let it go. It's like holding on to bricks. It's easy at first, until you get hurt again. After a while, you have so many things, you need more hands. Okay, good, now I can carry all this stuff. But why would you want to? It's not punishing anyone, it's just making your life super inconvenient and doesn't hurt anyone but yourself. It's like drinking poison and expecting it to hurt the other person. Carrying around heavy weights forever. Having a scab that never heals because you won't stop picking at it. Unforgiveness is keeping hurts from others inside and letting the pressure build and build until... It's like holding hot coals. Grabbing a snake and expecting it not to bite you. Holding onto a burning match. Never taking your garbage out. Unforgiveness is a really bad thing. You might look good on the outside, but after a while, the nastiness inside will make its way out. Forgiving doesn't mean the person who hurt you was right. It means letting go of weight that you don't need to carry. Life is so much easier when you're not holding on to extra hurts. Imagine how much better it will be when you're not holding on to that pain. God forgave us, so we need to forgive others. We need to let it go.
It's really good when we can just let things go. And not just let them go, but let them go by giving them to Jesus. You see, Jesus says that we can cast our cares on Him because He cares for us. And you may not realize it, or maybe you do, but sometimes we can have unforgiveness in our heart without realizing it. And the best thing to do is, well, two things. First thing is we have to realize that in order to forgive people and give forgiveness, that we first have to receive it. You and I have been forgiven by the greatest person who ever walked the face of this earth, Jesus. Because Jesus died on a cross for our sins. The Bible says that while we were sinners, while we were doing things that made God's heart sad, that Jesus died for us to forgive us of our sins, to wipe away our debt. So you, first off, have to realize that you've been forgiven, and all you have to do is receive that forgiveness. And then when you realize that you've been given the greatest gift of forgiveness to ever be given, you can walk in forgiveness towards other people. And this is when we ask the Holy Spirit to help us look inside of our heart and figure out if there's anything, any person, any circumstance or situation that we might be holding unforgiveness towards. Like, maybe it's someone at your school. Maybe they said something or did something or did something to someone else, and although you want to like them, it's really hard because you just can't forgive them for what they've done. Or maybe it's one of your siblings. Maybe they broke something of yours or did something to you. Maybe it's someone in your family. Maybe it's something that happened to your family from someone else. The best thing to do when things happen to us is to follow the way of Jesus, to realize that because we've been forgiven and we have been loved with the best love to ever, ever, ever be shown, that we can in turn forgive and love other people, even if we feel like they don't deserve it. So you may be sitting here right now wondering, what's next? Well, we're gonna put two questions up on the screen, the ones that we just talked about, and you're gonna take some time to ask God these questions. We're gonna get quiet and we're gonna listen and we're gonna ask God to speak to us. And when God speaks, everything changes. So God, I ask that you would open our ears to hear your voice. God, I pray that when you speak, we would hear it, that we would believe it, and God, it would cause things in our heart to change. God, I thank you for these kids that are here right now. I pray that as we listen to you and become more like you, that this week, as we walk in forgiveness, as we look like Jesus, that you would help us to do justice, love mercy, walk humbly. You're so good. It's in Jesus' name. Everybody said, amen.